Hello. Well, I thought I'd share with you my barn. It's been a while since we've talked about barns, and last week I showed you how I scrubbed the barn through an inch of its life, and I disinfected it and jet washed it and so on and so forth. And I thought, well, today I'm going to be disinfecting the barn again with a formulated powder with hydrated lime. So I thought, well, before I do that, I thought I'll just give you a little run around of the barn and hopefully encourage some of you to also show us some of your barns and what you've got. So this is my barn, everyone, and I bring in the sows and the boar for in winter, because living down here in West Devon and on the borders of Cornwall, we suffer terrifically with wet weather, and we have clay soil, and it's not much fun when it gets wet. It gets very tacky, and it becomes very boggy, and it's not good for the pigs, and they don't like it. And so I'm lucky enough to be able to bring the pigs in winter. So the barn here is 65 feet long by about 50 wide. I've got water and electricity in the barn. So I've had and converted the back end, which is stables, and I thought, right, so what shall I do to make it a little bit more manageable and workable? And I had a lovely friend of mine called Paul Jones, who's a welder amongst other things, make me these lovely panels. So we've got wooden panels here on the side, and it just makes it extra warm, prevents drafts, and each pen is divided by barriers which are made of weld mesh. Reason being is because all the pigs can see each other, say hello, have a chat, and it's sociable, and they feel as if they're just not being separated, and it's just nice, isn't it? So each pen is different. I've got earth ground, concrete, in some with earth ground again. So this pen that I'm in now is concreted on one side, which is where they eat, and I put their water bowls down. And this side here is earth on the ground, and I just put straw on the top. This is what I was talking about, which is their ensuite, which is an area which I put shavings down, wood shavings. So that's where they have they do their toilet business. And next door is exactly the same. Again, concrete flooring. And as we go back outside, and I also incidentally use the barns for bringing the sows in when they farrow. And I do that because I feel that I can be hands-on. They've got the space, I've got the light, and I can see and help them if there are any difficulties. That's my preference, but as you know, we can keep our pigs outside all year long, and they do stay out all year long, and they farrow outside. So it's just how we want to do it, how it works for us, and how we feel comfortable. So there's no wrong way, there's no right way. Pigs can be indoors and outdoors as long as the space is big enough. And obviously the most obvious thing is you're keeping it clean and tidy. So if any of you are in the process of making your barns and adapting them and converting them and trying to think how to best use the space, there's one thing that I would say is having gates put in, obviously, but have them being able to swing both ways. So they swing out and then they swing in. And this really does work. So it was very convenient. I wish I had it done with all of them, but I didn't. And another thing that I did have made was a connecting door between a pen. Now, this has worked. I haven't used it all the time, but it's there, and it works for instance. One time I had two farrowings happening at the same time, so I was able to go in between two pens at the same time quite nicely. Also separating sows from their piglets at weaning time. That has worked tremendously. And also moving a ball from one sow to another, which has also been a great help. I've got a little radio there for them during the day when they're in over winter. And another thing which has worked for me is I had to make a fourth pen, which is this one here. And it was predominantly what is earth. So as you can see, it was a wall, a solid wall. So I cut an opening in the side there and round to the other side, put a barrier in between, but I made another connecting door. Now this door has worked brilliantly because it's like an inspection pen or a holding pen. And it has worked for me when saying if I want to inspect all the wieners, if I bring the boar in, have their tusks removed, if I want to inspect a sow, if I want to vaccinate. It serves a purpose, and it has helped out now and again. So it was just something that worked. So this is the pen that just works and divides. And again, it's used for moving the ball to the sow, which it has helped, or then making it just one big pen so the pens can be joined together. So you can see they would have this area and that area to roam around in. So if that's a boar and a sow, or again, having a sow with her piglets, and when it comes to weaning time, I can leave the piglets in there, get the door, close the door, and then sow is separated from wieners, and then I can walk the sow out and back out into the field, into her paddock. Earlier this year, I introduced some new lighting into the barn, which are energy saver strip lights. They have produced a very strong, bright light. I've been pleasantly surprised by them, actually. And as we're all looking at saving money and helping our pockets, this has been really, really good and very efficient. So what I've done is I think I've changed, I've put two in here and I've got to replace another two. And it's great for winter. So come 3 o'clock, 3:30 in winter, I put the lights on and they stay on until around about 6:30. So it adds an extra brightness to the day while they're inside. This is the hydrated lime that I've been talking to you about earlier that I'm going to be sprinkling on the barn later on. And here's my medicine cabinet. Yes, it's a bit tatty, but it's clean, and it keeps all my medicines and drenches and whatnot inside, safe and sound. And here is my feed bin. And yes, I have a fridge. And my fridge is for keeping any spinach that I get, any apples that I pick from the orchard, loganberries that I've got grown behind the barn here. So it keeps everything away as it should from the kitchen. So there's no contamination and everything's safe. And the left is my big feed bin. I also have some blue bins I put feed in should I need to. So that's my barn, everyone. I hope you found it interesting, and please do share your ideas of your barn as well and give us some extra ideas, because it's always nice to see what everybody else is doing, how they're doing it. And now I'm going to do some sprinkling.